online service. You are joining Joy Lee today, and our current series is called To the Cross. Have you ever heard someone say, "It isn't fair"? Well, we say this when brothers or sisters or friends that someone we know takes something away from us, or someone gets in trouble and it's not their fault. Well, today's Bible story, we're going to learn about a person who lived a sinless life, but they got arrested, they got put on a trial, and got sentenced to death. Well, do you think that's fair? It isn't. Let's find out more. There are a total of 66 books in the Bible, and we are studying one verse from each book. So that's a total of 66 verses we are going to study together in order. Today, we are finally studying the 17th book. But before we get started, let's all say the 16 books in order. You guys ready? Let's do it together. 3, 2, 1. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, 2 Kings, 1 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, and the 17th book is called Esther. What was that again? Esther. And today's power verse comes from chapter 4, 14. Let's all read it together. Go. Who knows if perhaps you were made queen for just such a time like this. Amen. Now, Queen Esther did not want to miss the opportunity to be served by God. She risked her own life to save her people. And I really admire Esther's courage.
same. So hold on tight and follow real close. God is good and he's in control. Clap your hands like this. Now do the twist. Stomp your feet the same.
Over the past couple of weeks, we have been learning about Jesus' final week here on earth before he died on the cross. Jesus entered Jerusalem and people welcomed him as their king. But his enemies, they wanted to trick Jesus. They did not like how Jesus said he is the Messiah. So they started asking Jesus all these difficult questions, but Jesus answered them with wisdom and authority. Last week, we learned how Jesus had a very special meal with his disciples, a Passover meal. This helped the disciples to understand God's big plan of salvation. And Jesus commanded them to remember his sacrifice. In today's story, we're going to learn about how Jesus got arrested. Now, he didn't do anything wrong, but he took the punishment of our sins, past, present, and future sins. Let's find out more.
Jesus came with his disciples to a garden called Gethsemane. He said to them, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." Jesus took three of his disciples into the garden, and Jesus became very sad and troubled. Jesus told the three disciples to stay there, and he went a little farther. Jesus fell face down and prayed, "Father, if it is possible, spare me from this, but I want to do your plan." Jesus came back and found the three disciples asleep. He asked Peter, "Couldn't you stay awake with me for 1 hour?" Jesus went away and prayed a second time. Then he found his disciples sleeping again. He said, "Are you still asleep? Get up, for it is almost time. Someone is going to betray me." Suddenly, Judas arrived with a large crowd carrying swords and clubs. Judas kissed Jesus so the crowd would know which man was Jesus. The men grabbed Jesus and arrested him. Peter pulled out his sword to fight the man, but Jesus told Peter to put away his sword. Jesus said, "Isn't this what God planned all along?" Jesus' followers ran away, but Peter stayed nearby to watch. The men who arrested Jesus led him to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest. The religious leaders wanted a reason to kill Jesus, but they couldn't find one. The high priest asked, Do you have anything to say? Are you the Messiah, the Son of God? Jesus replied, Yes, that's right. The high priest said, Aha, he has spoken against God. Caiaphas and the religious leaders did not want to believe that Jesus is God's son. They said Jesus was lying, but Jesus was telling the truth. The crowd said, He deserves to die. They spit in Jesus' face and hit him. A servant saw Peter and asked, Aren't you one of Jesus' disciples? No, I'm not, Peter said. Twice more, as Peter watched what was happening to Jesus, someone asked him if he was a follower of Jesus. Peter lied. No, he said. I don't even know him. The next morning, the religious leaders decided how they would kill Jesus. Then they took him to Pilate, the governor. Jesus knew that his death was God's plan to save people from sin. Jesus' friends turned against him and he was arrested and put on trial. But Jesus followed his Father's plan in order to bring salvation to the world.
Bible story started in a garden called Gethsemane. Have you ever experienced a time when you knew exactly what to do, but you were afraid to do it? I know I have, and we've always experienced something like this. And this is exactly how Jesus felt as he was praying in a garden. And he knew that he was going to soon be betrayed and get arrested. Do you remember his prayer? Let's all read that together. Matthew chapter 26, verse 9. Go. My Father, if it is possible, let this cup of suffering be taken away from me. Yet, I want your will to be done, not mine. Amen. Jesus prayed, asking God to spare him from what was coming. But Jesus also told his Father that he wants to obey and follow his plan. Now, obeying God's plan meant getting arrested, getting hurt, getting made fun of, getting hit and killed. But Jesus was ready to be committed to follow God's plan. What part of today's story was not fair? That's right. That one of Jesus' disciples, Judas, betrayed him and that he got arrested. Now, this was not fair, but Jesus knew what was coming because this was all God's plan to save us. And in the midst of this difficult time that Jesus was going through, Jesus placed God's glory above his feelings because when his enemies came to arrest him, Jesus did not fight back. He did not even let Peter fight his enemies. What Jesus did was that Jesus allowed his enemies to arrest him. Now let's read all that together. Verse 52 and 54 in one voice. Go. Put away your sword, Jesus told him. Those who use the sword will die by the sword. Don't you realize that I could ask my Father for thousands of angels to protect us, and he would send them instantly? But if I did, how would the scriptures be fulfilled that describe what must happen now? Jesus said that this is what God had been planning all along. Now, Jesus, he could have totally stopped everything. Jesus could have stopped Judas, he could have stopped the soldiers, and he could have even stopped the religious leaders. But he didn't. Jesus' enemies, they did not care about fair or justice. They just wanted Jesus dead. And Jesus, he allowed his enemies to arrest him because he knew that his death is going to be part of God's big plan. You know what the religious leaders and the enemies, what they did not know was that God was using their evil plans to create something beautiful and wonderful. That when Jesus dies, that God was going to save people from sin and death, and that he was going to bring salvation to this world. Now, Jesus, because of him, we are free from punishment of sin, and we have this eternal life. Let's all get up and celebrate this wonderful salvation that we have received because of Jesus. Let's all praise his name. Let's all close our eyes and pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for your mercy and grace. Only you can save and give us eternal life. Help us live our lives in obedience and service to you and tell others about the free gift of salvation. Help us to be bold and courageous. In Jesus' name we all pray. Amen. I want to challenge you this week. We learned today how Jesus allowed his enemies to arrest him. And there are many ways to lay down our lives for others. Laying down our lives means putting aside our own desires to help others. And this is not going to be easy because we have to look for opportunities to help others and to show others about Jesus's love. So that's what I want you to do this week. Each day, I want you to look for ways to lay down your life, to show others that you care for them and that you love them and share Jesus's love, just like what Jesus did for us.
I'm feeling good, good, good in a crazy way. God's love changed me more than I can say. Can't keep this in, gotta let it out. Gonna tell the whole world that your love is spinning me round and around. Yeah, it's turning me upside down. I can't believe the way you love.
Okay, guys, it is time to say goodbye. I had a wonderful time with you learning about Jesus's final week here on earth. Now, don't forget to return next week because it is going to be the last part of this series. You guys take care and have a wonderful week. Bye-bye.